Hey, good evening, everybody. Brother Stewart. Hey, Tanya. How's everybody doing? Hey, Cookie. Hey, IG. Hey sis, what's going on? We'll get started in a few minutes. We'll get a couple of people that log in. Love you too, sis. How mom doing? All right, we'll go ahead and get started, everybody. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Thankful Thursdays in the Word. I'm Reverend Clayton E. Taylor, Jr. I'm glad y'all could join me here for another night, another week. I'm praying everyone is doing well thus far. Everyone having a great week. We made it to another Thursday. By the grace of God, I'm glad you all join me for another night tonight. Like I tell you every week, I won't hold you long. So tonight, I'm definitely gonna be brief tonight. Just have like one verse of scripture, kind of like been on my spirit for the past couple of weeks. It's something kind of been speaking to my heart and my spirit, and I pray something I say tonight will speak to yours as well. Before we go into the scripture, let's go into a word of prayer. Eternal Father, our great God, we thank you for another day. We thank you for this time spent with you. I'm praying, Father, tonight that you will say something to me that I'll be able to deliver to your people. I pray that you be in me tonight. Let me be your mouthpiece. I pray that I may decrease and you may increase in me. Use me tonight, Father, for your purpose and for your glory. And Father, that whatever be said tonight will be for the edification of your people. Father, I ask right now to have your way tonight. We praise you. We honor you. We give you all the glory. It's in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Like I said, I have only one verse of scripture tonight. It's going to come out of the book of Psalms. Psalms 139, verse 14. Familiar verse of scripture. Many of us have heard plenty of times throughout our lifetime. It's Psalms 139, verse 14. And it reads, I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. I want to read it one more time. I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. Tonight, for a few minutes, I want to speak on this topic. Be who God made you to be. Be who God made you to be. Tonight, except for a few minutes, I want to just talk about finding the real you. Finding the person God created you to be. Not somebody else, not someone who you emulate or admire. No, I want to talk to the person who God created. I want to talk to you, who got the person that God created to be. When I look at this verse tonight, it just reminds me just how special we are. We're special because God made us. He made us unique. He made us for his good works. I mean, it says that in scripture, God created us for his good works. See, God created each and every one of us for his divine purpose. See, and I truly believe once you realize this, it'll help you through all situations you may face in life, especially times when you feel hopeless, feel defeated, feel discouraged. When you just meditate on this verse, it'll kind of like, it'll tell you that you are fearfully and you're wonderfully made. I came to find out in my own life, days when I feel lost, days when I felt hopeless, days I didn't feel like I didn't amount to anything in life, stressed out. Once I meditated on this scripture, what it did, kind of like, it made me realize that my life matters. And once you realize who your life matters to the most, you don't care what the world thinks about you. You don't care what people think about you, because you know who you matter to. David says right here, now this verse tonight, David says, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. See, knowing this, David says right here, David said he can do nothing but praise the Lord. It was praise on his lips. See, whenever you know who you are in Christ, when you know whose you are, it cannot help but give God nothing but praise. You praise him because you know you're special. You're special in his eyes. It doesn't matter what nobody, anybody, okay, family, friends, whoever it is, it don't matter what they think or what they say, because you know that you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You don't have to go around trying to pretend to be somebody else, be a carbon copy of somebody else. No, because you know you're made in God's image. God created you for good works. See, when you understand this, you'll understand that you have a purpose in this earth. Because God created you for a purpose. See, we all need to have the same mindset David has here in our text tonight. We have to know that we are fearfully and wonderfully made. God made you for a divine purpose. And God made you to do some great things in life. And you're going to accomplish those things that God created you for. Because he is faithful to do what he has promised for your life. So tonight, like I said, it won't be long, I promise you. I just want to give you a few things to help you remember just why God created you. Why you are fearfully and wonderfully made. So let me give you just a few things to remember to show you why God made you different. Why God created you. The first thing I want you to see is point number one. He created you to stand out from the world. I'm going to say that again. He created you to stand out from the world. God made us. He made all of us in his image. Genesis 1:27, it says it right there. God made us in his own image. You see, you have a uniqueness about you. You have a piece of God. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. That means you're special. So ain't no sense you walk around having little pity parties, feeling sorry for yourself. No. God made you. That means you're special. He made you to stand out above the rest. He made you stand out because he has something great for your life. Days when you feel sorry for yourself, days when you feel like you're not going to make it, days when you feel you're not going to amount to nothing, days when you catch a hell on your job, catch a hell in your house, you have to realize, no matter what you go through in life, no matter how tough, no matter how hard it gets, God can get you through anything that you may face day in and day out. Why? David tells us tonight, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. So whatever you go through, you are equipped And God made you to accomplish anything that comes, anything that comes against you. You're able to get through that thing. I don't care what it is. Because God made you different. He created you to stand out from the world. See, the world, it will throw all types of things at you. It will throw depression at you. It will throw discouragement at you. It will throw hate at you. All type of things that will make you feel defeated, make you feel bad in life. No, God made you stand out from all that. God made you to be a winner, to be a champion. See, when you know who you are and what God created you to be, nothing that this world throws at you will hinder you or beat you down, because you are able to walk through this thing with your head held high, knowing God is with you, knowing God made you for a divine purpose in this world. So you have to know, God created you for a special purpose. And the first thing he created you for, he created you to stand out from the world. Romans 12:2 says, do not be conformed to this world, but we have to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. So you have to renew your mind by telling yourself that you are special, by telling yourself that you are fearfully and that you are wonderfully made. See, and this will help you get through the things that the world may throw at you. So the first thing we see tonight is God created you to stand out from the world. The second thing God created you for, point number two, God created you to live a blessed life. See, that helped me right there, because times my own life, even yesterday, days when I felt defeated, days when I felt I wanted to give up, I had to remind myself, God created me to live a blessed life. I ain't trying to put no prosperity teaching to you tonight. I'm just telling you what I know. I'm telling you what I believe. God did not create me to walk around with my head down, to be stressed out, be worried about what people think about me, be worried about what people say about me. God didn't create me for none of that stuff. No, he didn't. He created me to live a blessed life. Jesus, he tells us right there in John 10:10, I have come that you may have life more abundantly. That's what he came for, you to live a blessed life. Your life is not meant to be stressed out. Your life is not meant to be catching hell from your boyfriend, from your girlfriend, from your wife or your husband. Your life is meant to be the best you can be. And God made you to live a blessed life. Why? Because you are his child. You are part of the royal priesthood. You are a child of the king. When you know who your father is, you know that everything that in this world that you are entitled to. I don't care. You're entitled to have wealth. You're entitled to live in a nice home with a roof over your head. I don't care if it's an apartment. I don't care what it is. You are designed to live a blessed life. I don't care if you don't have a car, you riding on the bus, you can still ride that bus saying I'm blessed. I don't care. You are God's child. You are a child of the king. Know who you are. Know why God created you. He created you to live a blessed life. So we see tonight, God created us to stand out from the world. And now we see right here, point number two. He created you to live a blessed life. And third and finally, and I'll be done with my short little message tonight. First thing we see, God created us to stand out from the world. Then we see he created us to live a blessed life. And the third and final thing I want you to get, God created you to bless others. God says you are fearfully and you're wonderfully made. You are fearfully and wonderfully made because God blessed you so you can be a blessing to somebody else. He created each and every one to be a blessing to other people. See, this is all part of being Christ-like. See, if we are made in the image of God, then we have to live just how Jesus Christ lives. That's right. We have to serve mankind. We have to love on people. We have to go out. We have to feed the homeless. We have to save that lost child. We have to encourage those who feel hopeless. That's right. God created you to bless others. That's why every day, either it's at the barbershop, either it's on Facebook, social media, whatever. Every day, I try to give something to somebody that will be a blessing and encouragement to their life. Because I know God, He has me here for a reason. He has me here to live a blessed life, to live life pleasing to Him, live a life that's going to bless my own spiritual journey. But God brought us here, each and every one of us, as agents to be a blessing to other people's lives. Because you don't know what somebody else is going through day in and day out. You don't know what that person going through on your job, who you sit down next to every day when they're quiet, when they're not saying nothing. You don't know what they're going through. But through the Holy Spirit, God can use you to be a blessing, either by word or deed, that will be a blessing to their life, that will give them something to help them to continue to see another day. You have to know that God created you to be a blessing to others. That child who's going through it, the child who's not feeling loved at home, the child who's doing everything in school they're not supposed to be doing. God can use you to be a mentor to that child, to speak life to that child. That person who's going through a marriage difficulty. God can use you to speak encouragement, to speak words of advice. God can use you to be a blessing to that person, to help them out through their marriage. The person who has lost a loved one. You could be a blessing, just speak words of comfort, words of peace. You could send a prayer just for them, to give them hope, to give them some type of encouragement, to keep going, to help them not to give up in life. You see, God created you to be a blessing to others. So as David taught us tonight in this one little verse of scripture, we are fearfully and wonderfully made. God blessed us to be a blessing to others. God created us to stand out from the world. God created us to live a blessed life. So child of God, when you're catching hell, when you're going through it, when you're stressed out, when you feel like giving up, I behoove you just to go to Psalms 139 verse 14 and tell yourself, just like David says, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. And God, I'm going to praise you because I know you have great things for my life. I guarantee you meditate on this one little verse. It'll help you through your dark days. It'll help you through your down days. It'll help you through them days when you just feel like you can't take it no more. Because when you know who you are, and when you know whose you are, can't nothing break you, can't nothing defeat you, because you know you are a child of the King. So I pray tonight was something beneficial. Like I said, it was short and sweet. Like I said, it's just something that's on my spirit, just reminding myself who I am in Christ Jesus, knowing that I am fearfully and wonderfully made. So I pray it was something that I said tonight that kind of stuck to your spirit, stuck to your heart, that kind of remind you like when you're going through it in life. So I pray it was a blessing. And like I said, I just hope it's something you can just take from and run on. Let us pray. Eternal Father, our great God, we thank you for another night. We thank you for this word. I pray that it was a blessing to the hearers tonight. I pray for each and every one that's online tonight. I pray that you would bless their homes. I pray, Father, that you would bless their lives. I pray that you enrich them mightily with your Holy Spirit. And Father, I thank you for reminding us that we are fearfully and we are wonderfully made. And Father God, long as we know that, we'll continue to give you all the praise and continue to give you all the glory. Father, because you alone are worthy of the praise. So Father, we thank you. We love you. We lift up your holy name tonight. It's in the magnificent, marvelous, and mighty name of Jesus that we pray. Amen. Well, family, we did it again. Made it through another night. I pray you all have a blessed rest of the week, and I pray you have a great Super Bowl weekend. So, no, that should be fun. I got a good game this Sunday. So, until we meet again, be blessed. Know that I love you, and God loves you more. Peace.